Welcome back to Future Stars. He's from the Eastern Rangers. He went number two in the national draft last year. He's a supremely talented individual. But then on February 16 this year, he ruptured his ACL and he's going to sit out his entire first year. I speak of Melbourne young gun Christian Petracca. Thanks for joining us today, mate.
Thanks for having us.
I guess take us back to February 16. You're at training, you're feeling good, looking forward to playing your first round of practice matches, and you do your knee, similar to Chris Judd yesterday, but at the end of his career.
Yeah, it's a pretty frustrating injury. It's happened quite frequently in the AFL recently with the ACLs, but only so much you can do, really. So I was just playing, you know, training, really, and doing a game simulation drill, and just twisted awkwardly, and didn't think I did it, actually. I thought I just hyperextended it and started running after it, and got the scan later and confirmed ACL.
Well, we promised you the highs and lows when you're on this show about 12 months ago, and let's talk about some of the highs for a start, because you won the Lark Medal, the best and fairest in the National Championship,
yep.
And of course you ended up the second choice in the draft. What were the memories of those two occasions for you last year?
Oh, it's something that, you know, hold me for the rest of my life. Massive honour and privilege being the Lark medalist, and then obviously being selected to Melbourne, such a great history in the AFL, and to be drafted by them, it's a massive honour, and just so humbled to be there, yeah.
You know what I like about every time I've read an article about you or you've done an interview, how confident you are in your own ability. You've got, you've got some swagger about you, and I like that coming in, because you need that. If you're going to play AFL and you're going to be the number two or number one pick, you're going to need that, and you haven't taken a backward step through this injury process. You've been positive the whole way through it, and I think it's a great honour to you.
Yeah, obviously I'm a pretty upbeat kid. There's no point dwelling on it. The injury's done, and you just got to move on, and hopefully can set a good goal for hopefully round one next year or day one of pre-season. So there's no point being negative about it. It's something that hopefully set me back for a short time, and I'll be back ready to play.
Now, a couple of young guys that you're probably going to develop your career with at the footy club are Angus Brayshaw and also Jesse Hogan. You played footy with Angus as a Vic Metro player, and now you're transitioning to AFL. What's that like, transitioning with actually a friend and a good mate?
Oh, it's helped the AFL life so much easier, being someone who I've actually looked up to in terms of playing that midfield role, and off the field he's so professional, and he's a great bloke, and being drafted with a good mate, it's just so good, because he's always there with you in the change rooms, and we probably do get sick of each other a little bit. There's a bit of competition between us, but it just helps. It makes life so much easier being with him.
Yep. And also, another one is Simon Goodman, the midfield coach. You spoke about you and Angus playing in the midfield. What's he brought to the table, life at Melbourne Footy Club? He obviously was at Essendon for a couple of years as a coach, and just a midfield influence on you and Angus.
I think the best thing about Goodman is he's played in our generation, so he knows what it's like to be a midfielder and what it takes, and sort of similar, I guess, body physique that we played at, just that sort of higher weight, and he's someone that I've always really look towards to get a lot of analysis and a lot of videotape off him, and he's been great for both of us.
We spoke about confident people. Paul Ruse is a confident person, and I think a very positive person as well. How have you found him?
He's been great. Right from day one, he's made life so much easier. He's so easy to talk to and approach, and he's always there for feedback and a lot of advice, and he's good with a lot of guidance, yeah.
Now, tomorrow's a huge day for the football club. The Freeze MND walk is on tomorrow to the MCG. Obviously, Neil Danaher come down to the club the other week. Were you fortunate enough to be in that meeting with Neil at all?
Yeah, I was. I was fortunate enough to be in that meeting. It was just so inspirational. I nearly had a tear run down my cheek, because of just what he's done for the footy club and I guess in general. It's just unbelievable, and we've already raised over $1 million for the foundation and the charity, and it's something so special, and he's a true inspiration to not just Melbourne but to the AFL life in general.
And quickly, before we let you go, you went number two, Paddy McCartan went number one at St Kilda. Yeah. When did you know that you're going to go to number two at Melbourne?
I probably knew that a couple of hours before the draft. I wanted it to be a surprise, but at the same time, I sort of wanted to know my fate, really. But, as I said before, it's a massive honour to be a part of the Melbourne Football Club.
So, from talking to your penciling in day one pre-season, you'll be coming back from your injury.
Yeah, I like to hope so, yeah.
Mate, we can't wait to see you tearing up the MCG next year. You're a great young kid, you've got a great attitude, and we're really looking forward to it. Thanks for joining us on Future Stars.
Thank you very much. Thanks
and you're going to win all the prizes that players are just going to read through now.